You mentioned AUKUS there. I listened to the Deputy Prime Minister, the Defence Minister Richard Marles today in Question Time. Pretty scathing about the Coalition and AUKUS. Of course, the Coalition are the ones who developed and signed AUKUS, but you wouldn't know it if you listened to Richard Marles. Let's have a listen.
When we came to power, AUKUS was really not much more than a thought bubble. But since then, we have been turning it into a reality.
Andrew Hastie, your response?
I thought it was pretty childish. I think AUKUS is the most consequential thing the Coalition government did in office. And it's a national endeavour, it's bipartisan, it's multi-generational, and it's got to be above cheap political point scoring, which is exactly what Richard Marles did in Parliament today. We need to be working together to make this thing happen. It's his job to implement it, and we give the project bipartisan support. So instead of landing cheap blows in Parliament, he should be focused on the job. And I can tell you there's a lot of work to be done, not just with the federal government, but also with the WA state government. And I called on them last week to establish an AUKUS minister in the state cabinet to get the thing rolling, because Labor have dropped the ball on AUKUS.
Let's go to comments from the ASIO boss, Mike Burgess, yesterday, that harbouring Hamas sympathies, he said, is not necessarily a deal breaker when it comes to getting an Australian visa. Have a listen.
If they've expressed any support or sympathy for Hamas, is that a problem?
Depends on the what that looks like. If they're supportive because they want their homeland, if they're giving financial support or material aid, that can be a problem. And obviously we take each case on its merits and the context of the information we have before us.
But if it's just rhetorical support?
If it's just rhetorical support and they don't have an ideology or support for a violent extremism ideology, then that's not a problem. If they have a support for that ideology, that will be a problem.
Your colleague James Patterson doesn't agree at all. He says the only acceptable number of Hamas supporters in Australia is zero. The ASIO boss talked about security checks, but he made the admission that they only check those that are referred to them. And we know not many get referred on. You're one of the few politicians who's actually picked up a gun to fight terrorists, Andrew. What's your view on this?
I got a lot of respect for Mike Burgess, and he's a pretty straight shooter. But on this question, I disagree. I think that if you sign up or support the Hamas charter, directly or indirectly, I don't see how you can't be supporting violent, radical behaviour, the sort that we saw on October 7th last year. It's in the Hamas charter. They are committed to the destruction of the Jewish people and the state of Israel. That's why they use the words from the river to the sea. These people don't negotiate. So if we have people coming to Australia who support Hamas, all we're doing is inviting more radicalism into Australia, which will damage our social cohesion and potentially, lead to other consequences.
I made the point earlier in the show, Muslim countries in the region, neighbours of the Gaza area, Egypt, Jordan, obviously a little bit further along, Saudi Arabia, they refuse to take in anyone from Gaza. Why is this Australia's problem to fix from this great distance away? And the fact that these countries don't want anyone from Gaza, given the predominance of Hamas, that says something, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, it does. And Hamas is a radical organisation committed to the destruction of Israel. So people who sign up to that or support that, we have big problems with. If other Muslim countries have problems with that, then we should be looking very closely at this. And I think anyone who supports Hamas should not be allowed into Australia. It's as simple as that. It's a pretty straight line, which is why I support what Senator James Patterson said yesterday, or today, rather.
We like you for your clarity, Andrew Hastie. Thanks for your time.